everyone, this is Yana Smakula here at Spellbinders, and thank you for joining me today. In this video, I'll show you how to use Build a House die by Sharyn Sowell from her Joyous Celebration line to create adorable woodland houses that can hold little treats, gifts, or simply decorate your home. I'm going to be using Build a House die for this project. Here's a quick look at some of the houses I already made. You can make these any color you like. I used pattern paper with a wood grain print to create a cabin in the woods type of houses. But you can also use more bright and happy colors to create the house that you like. This house die comes with many bits and pieces and allow you to easily customize your project. You also have a fence that you can put around the house for a nice country look and feel. You can add windows to the roof of your house, and you can even make it so that it opens so you can place a tea light candle or little gifts inside. Let me turn the lights off and quickly show you how the house looks with a candle inside. Of course, you want to use a battery-operated candle. So let me show you all the bits and pieces that are included in this die set. You have a die to cut the front and back of the house, another piece to create walls on the right and left sides. Next, there's a roof die, and this one not only cuts, but also adds a score line, so creates a hinge, so you can easily open your house to reach inside. This die can also be used to create a base of the house, and it can also open from the bottom. Next, there's a door and a window die. There's also a die to create window shutters, and it also can be used as a gate for the fence. It not only cuts, but adds a score line. There's a fence die, and this can be cut multiple times if you need to create a longer fence. And lastly, there's a little heart that you can decorate your house with. So let's go ahead and die cut the pieces. I'm going to use this beautiful pattern paper with a wood grain print, but keep in mind you can make these houses any way you like. Pink, yellow, purple, green, the sky is the limit. You can even use textured wood grain paper or wood-like paper for a more realistic look. To create the house, you'll need to die cut two of the front panels and two of the side panels. There's no need to emboss either, simply cut the pieces out. You'll also need to cut two pieces for the roof, and if you're using a roof die for the base, another piece for that as well. I'll be using a wood slice, so I'm only cutting two pieces. I ended up cutting the roof piece out of slightly darker wood grain pattern paper to add some contrast to my project. And I also cut a number of fence pieces to create a fence to go around the house. I did add double-sided sticky sheet to the back side of my paper before cutting half of the fence elements to make it easier to adhere them together. I also want to add a door and a window to my front house panel, and I like to place my die cut onto a cutting mat where I have some sort of a grid so I can better align and center my pieces. You can have a door and two windows, or a door and just one window. You can also add windows to the side panels and the back panel, and even to the roof. I'm going with two windows next to the door, and I'm also adding a diagonal window on the second floor of the house. To be able to adhere our die-cut windows back onto the die-cut, I'm going to create another front panel out of vellum. This will create a screen in between the house, in between the outside and the inside, and will let me adhere the die-cut windows back onto the main panel. Of course, you can skip die-cutting doors and windows in the main panel and simply cut them out of other color paper and just adhere onto the project. But I wanted to be able to see through to the inside of my project. I need to cut a few more pieces before I can start putting this project together. I'm going to use fun foam, and I'm adding scrapbook adhesives, adhesive sheets, to both sides of my foam to create a double-sided sticker. I will use this foam to die-cut a door and three windows to add a little bit of dimension to my house. I'll also use the inside negative pieces from the windows to adhere faux bricks and add some interest to this project. Now let's start putting the house together. I'm going to first adhere the vellum die-cut onto the front house panel, and I'm adhering it from the inside to create a screen. Next, fold on all score lines on your die-cuts and add adhesive. You can use glue or double-sided sticky tape. I prefer to use red tape as it's mess-free and is very strong. First, I'm going to adhere the side panels onto the front panel, and then we'll adhere the back panel. To add some shading to my house, I'm going to use my 2-in-1 and a round ink blending foam, and we'll blend some ink onto the edges. You can do this before you adhere the pieces together, meaning right after you die cut them, or after, like I'm doing here. Next, I'm going to adhere the house onto a base. I'm using a wood slice, but you can also use a roof die cut to create a base for your house, or you can even adhere it onto a lid of the box to create a unique gift box topper. Let's work on our windows now. I'm going to adhere the window and door die cuts, the paper die cuts, onto fun foam die cuts. Because I added sticky on the both sides of the foam before cutting it, it's now very easy to adhere both paper die cuts onto foam and later foam onto the house. I'm also adding some ink to the edges of my windows to add some interest. Finally, I'm going to adhere the roof. There's already adhesive added to the tabs that will connect the roof to the house, so I'm just going to remove backing paper and will align the die cut. I'm placing the walls of the house in between the first and the second scallops on each side. The second part of the roof, even though I already have adhesive added to all tabs, I'm only going to adhere to the bottom tab, so that I will be able to open and close the house and place a little battery-operated candle inside. I still have all the tiny squares, the negatives from the windows, and I'm going to use those to add some texture to my roof of my house. I'm going to adhere pattern paper squares onto foam, and will adhere both onto the house. Finally, I'm going to do some more ink blending to darken the edges. We still have the fence to put together. I'm going to make my fence double-sided. I wanted to have this pretty wood grain paper on both front and back. Again, I'm inking the edges of the die cut and will use glue to adhere it onto the wood slice. You might need to sand the edge of the wood slice to be able to adhere it better. I did sand mine in one section, as I couldn't get the glue to stick down perfectly. Finally, I wanted to add some greenery to my house, and I used a gorgeous flower soft mix. I applied a generous amount of glue to the area in front of the house and around it on a wood slice. I used a paintbrush to spread the glue and added flower soft mix on top. You want to press it down with your finger after you apply it to make sure it sticks down nicely. Lastly, use a hole punch and punch holes in each roof panels to add strength to be able to close the roof panels and complete your project. Depending on how complex you want your house to be, it will take you anywhere from 20 minutes to about an hour to complete it. Here's a closer look at these easy, fun cabins in the woods created using Build a House die from Joyous Celebrations collection by Sharyn Sowell for Spellbinders. If you have any questions about this project, please leave them in the comments section below. And be sure to subscribe to Spellbinders YouTube channel for more education and inspiration. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye!